and welcome to Union Solidarity International. My name is Walton Pantlin and I'm in Glasgow, Scotland. And this is a special report into violence against trade unionists in Honduras. And I'm joined by Victor Crespo, who is at the ITF offices in London. Victor is a leader of the Port Workers Union, SGTM, in Honduras, which has been subject to violent repression after seeking recognition from the port management company. And there have been death threats and a number of very, very disturbing incidences which have happened and which have caused the new union leaders to have to go into hiding. Victor, welcome to the call, and please tell us the story in your own words.
Bueno, comienzo haciendo mi relato diciendo de que en nuestro país.
I'd like to begin this narrative by stating that in my country,
hay una clara violación a los derechos laborales de todos los trabajadores y trabajadoras, y por supuesto más que todo a los dirigentes sindicales.
There is a very clear violation of labor rights of all workers, male and female, particularly those of union leaders.
Y por tal razón, nuestra organización sindical ha sido completamente violentado los derechos de que tenemos como organización y como ciudadanos en nuestro país.
And that is why our union has been subject to violent repression of its rights as an organization in the country. And the rights of us as citizens as well.
Las amenazas de muerte y atentados contra dirigentes sindicales, dirigentes campesinos y todo lo que se oponga al gobierno, a lo que el gobierno tiene establecido, son reprimidos.
Anybody trying to act against or question the government has been the subject of death threats and also attacks, whether they be trade unionists, peasants, leaders, and in fact anybody fighting against the government have been subject to this repression of their rights.
Han habido dirigentes sindicales que han sido asesinados en el país.
Some trade union leaders in the country have been assassinated.
Y otros que hemos tenido que huir del país para salvaguardar nuestras vidas.
And others have been forced to flee the country in order to ensure their personal safety.
Y por tal razón, pues, desde septiembre del año 2013, yo estoy fuera de mi país, exiliado en otro país, como medida que en apoyo hizo ITF para salvaguardar mi vida.
So this has meant that, in fact, since September 2013, I've had to take exile abroad, and that was the result of support from the ITF who organized it.
Yo sufrí amenazas de muerte y un intento de asesinato en mi país.
I was the subject of death threats and even an attack on me when they tried to kill me in the
country. Mi familia ha sufrido las consecuencias también de mi labor.
And my family has also been hit very hard by, or as a result of my work.
Mi padre murió en 27 de enero de este año.
Because my father was actually killed on the 27th of January this year.
En un acto que la policía lo consideró como un accidente, la muerte de mi padre.
And in fact, it was an incident that the police described as simply an incident that the police described as an accident, but it was not that.
No tenemos garantías de parte del gobierno para salvaguardar a los dirigentes sindicales.
We have no guarantees, that is government guarantees, to protect union leaders.
La responsable de derechos humanos en la zona noroccidental del país, en San Pedro Sula, nos aconsejó que lo mejor que podía hacer yo en mi caso era salir del país y buscar asilo en otro país donde llegara.
And in fact, the head of human rights in the northwest of the country, San Pedro Sula, said that the best thing that I could do would be to take exile abroad.
Y bueno, el apoyo de ITF ha sido fundamental en colaboración también con la Federación de Sindical de Dinamarca 3F para llevarme a otro país y así garantizar que yo siguiera con vida.
So, essentially, the intervention of the ITF, its support, and also that of the Danish trade union 3F have been fundamental in allowing me to leave the country to achieve protection.
se presentó una denuncia contra el Estado de Honduras en la Corte Interamericana de Derechos Humanos, con sede en Costa Rica.
A complaint was brought against the state of Honduras in the Inter-American Court of Human Rights, which has its headquarters in Costa Rica.
Y es lo que se hizo para buscar que yo siguiera con vida. El movimiento sindical en mi país está fuertemente golpeado por el gobierno.
That was to ensure that my physical integrity would be ensured. The trade union movement has been very hard hit by the government and also by business people.
En la cual ha sido incapaz el ministerio de resolver la situación laboral en el país.
And the Ministry of Labor has been unable to solve the situation that exists in the country in terms of labor.
Han llegado al país a operar los puertos de Honduras una compañía filipina que es antisindical completamente, que es IPSI.
A completely union-busting type of company, which is Filipino, ICTSI has come into the country to run the ports.
Y por tal razón, el gobierno le concedió la operación de los puertos de Honduras por 30 años a partir de diciembre del año 2013.
And this is the company that the government has handed over a concession to run the port for 30 years.
En Puerto Cortés sabemos dos sindicatos afiliados a ITF.
In our port we have two trade unions that are ITF affiliates.
Y del sindicato, de los dos sindicatos han habido despidos desde que ITSI tomó control del puerto.
And since ICTSI came in to run the port, there have been redundancies amongst the members of both of these affiliates.
Y han sido despedidos los dirigentes sindicales de sus puestos de trabajo.
The trade union leaders have been sacked.
A pesar de que la ley de trabajo de Honduras les da un fuero sindical por ejercer sus funciones como dirigentes sindicales.
Even though under labor legislation these union leaders are allowed to exercise their functions as such.
Hasta seis meses después de cesar en sus funciones.
Until 6 months have passed after the labor contract has come to an end.
Y el mes, a finales del mes pasado, de febrero, fueron despedidos 10 dirigentes sindicales del otro sindicato de Citraen y 2 dirigentes sindicales del nuestro.
At the end of February, 10 union leaders from the other union, Citraen, were made redundant, and 2 of our union leaders also lost their jobs.
Y también fueron despedidos cerca de 200 trabajadores en total del puerto.
And a total of some 200 workers were made redundant in the port altogether.
Esta compañía filipina con una subsidiaria que creó en Puerto Cortés.
Now this Filipino company with its subsidiary that it set up in the port.
Hicieron firmar a los trabajadores un contrato de trabajo individual.
Forced the workers to sign individual job contracts,
en el que les impide a los trabajadores demandar por violaciones a los derechos laborales o derechos personales de los trabajadores al Estado, a la Empresa Nacional Portuaria, a ITSI, a OPC y a Coalianza.
And in this contract, the people were forced to sign a clause saying that they would not take any legal action in terms of violations of personal or labor rights. They wouldn't take any action against either the government, the National Docks Company, ICTSI, Coalianza,
es la que se encargó de privatizar el puerto,
which was the company actually in charge of the privatization exercise.
Obligados los trabajadores que quedaron en la empresa, obligados a adherirse a un pacto colectivo presentado por la empresa ante el Ministerio de Trabajo.
And the workers who did retain their jobs were actually obliged also to sign a collective agreement that was presented to the Labor Ministry by the company.
Y por tal razón, Hubieron protestas en el puerto.
There were protests over this in the port.
Y lo que protestaron, 15 miembros del sindicato de nosotros fueron arrestados.
And out of those protesting, 15 of our members were arrested.
Junto con 32 trabajadores del equipo pesado en Puerto Cortés.
Also 32 workers working with heavy equipment in the port.
Llevados detenidos ilegalmente a una instalación militar en Puerto Cortés.
They were illegally arrested and taken to military installations in the port, Puerto Cortés.
Detenidos a la intemperie por 24 horas.
They were held outside for 24 hours.
Y acusados criminalmente de terrorismo y daños a la economía nacional.
They were accused of terrorism and also damaging the national economy.
Logramos liberar a los 15 afiliados que fueron detenidos de nuestro sindicato.
We managed to achieve the freeing of 15 members of our union who had been arrested.
Los otros 32 compañeros fueron acusados ante la Poder Judicial de Honduras.
The other charges were brought against 32, the other 32.
Con una pena que contempla entre 8 y 20 años de cárcel.
And they could receive a sentence of between 8 and 20 years.
Por el simple hecho de protestar por la violación a sus derechos.
Simply for protesting against infringements of their rights.
El presidente de Honduras, Juan Orlando Hernández.
So Juan Orlando Hernández, the president of our country.
Recientemente declaró.
Recently stated.
Que cualquier manifestación que se haga, ya sea en forma pacífica o de cualquier índole.
That any demonstration that's carried out either peaceful or otherwise.
Va a ser reprimida y sacada de las calles.
Will be repressed, the people will be removed from the streets.
Y encarcelados los que la organizan.
And the organizers will be locked up.
Y que no va a permitir ningún tipo de manifestación de cualquier naturaleza en el país.
And that he's not going to allow any type of demonstration at all in the country.
Y por tal razón vemos que está más difícil todavía la defensa de los derechos humanos y la defensa de los derechos de los trabajadores.
So we see that the defense of human rights and labor rights has become even more complex.
Aunque esto poco o nada sale en los medios de comunicación que también son controlados por el gobierno.
Very little of all of this actually appears in the media being controlled by the government.
Recientemente se presentó solicitudes a la empresa OPC.
Recently requests were made to OPC, the company.
Y a Estir.
And Estir, another company.
De reconocimiento de los sindicatos como representantes de los trabajadores.
That the trade unions should be recognized as representatives of the workforces.
A lo cual se han negado rotundamente a reconocerlos.
But they've completely rejected this request.
Aún sabiendo de que los trabajadores que tienen son afiliados de nuestros sindicatos.
Even though they know that the people in question are members of our unions.
Y seguimos en la seguimos luchando, seguimos haciendo denuncias a nivel internacional.
So we continue to fight to bring in complaints in international to international fora.
Y con el apoyo de ITF y de todas las organizaciones internacionales que están ayudándonos.
And with the support of the ITF and all the international organizations that are assisting us.
Sabemos que vamos a llegar a la victoria.
We know that we will win.
Thank you. Thank you for that, Victor. That is truly a horrifying story. We're particularly sorry to hear about the death of your father. It's a shocking tragedy that this situation exists in the 21st century. Is it correct? I understood you to say that the ports were privatized, so it was a previously state-run port which has been privatized to this Filipino company.
Era un puerto que era del Estado y ha sido privatizado y ha pasado a manos de esta compañía filipina. Yes.
So en marzo del 2013,
March 2013,
la compañía filipina International Container Terminal Service, más conocido por las siglas de ITSI, ganó la licitación para operar el puerto de Cortés y pasó de ser del Estado a la compañía filipina mencionada por 30 años.
So it was actually in March that last year that this Filipino Philippine company ICTSI International Container Terminals Services Incorporated won this 30-year concession to run the port.
So this sounds very much to me like privatization through the barrel of a gun. It sounds like the most brutal form of neoliberalism that there is.
Sí, así ocurrió.
Yes, that's it. That's exactly what happened.
El 4 de diciembre que tomaron posesión, que tomó posesión ITSI para operar el puerto.
When on the 4th of December, when ICTSI actually came in, took to occupy the port to run it.
Llegó la compañía esta con un personal nuevo
The company arrived with new staff.
y queriendo desplazar a los trabajadores que estábamos en el puerto.
Wishing to actually displace those of us who are working in the port.
Y los trabajadores respondieron parando las operaciones del puerto.
Well, the response of the workforce was to bring about work stoppage in the port.
Para exigir que se les respetara el derecho que tienen al trabajo en sus puestos que habían sido contratados.
To demand that their rights to the jobs that they'd had until that time.
Y el gobierno envió al ejército y militarizó el puerto.
And the government sent in the army and the port became a militarized area.
Intimidando a los trabajadores para que desistieran del paro.
And they intimidated the workers to stop the stoppage, bring a halt to the stoppage.
Y unas horas más tarde habían logrado tomar el control del puerto y volver a hacer funcionar el puerto con otro personal que habían llevado.
And within just a few hours, the company managed to get back to running the port using the new staff that they had brought in.
Victor, that is a truly shocking and horrifying story. The level of violence and naked brutality of this political and economic system is just beyond words, and we'll do our best to get the word out there and to build solidarity for you and your members in the ports of Honduras. Once again, thank you for watching this special report from Union Solidarity International.